The last class, what we have seen is addition and subtraction of signed magnitude numbers. There are 8 different conditions to consider for addition and subtraction. All these things we have seen with examples in the last video. That is a plus a, when both are same sign, that is positive sign, then one is positive and one negative. In that case, when we are going to add, what will happen? Then same way, then when both are minus, same sign. In that case, how we are going to handle, and then during negative also the same logic, okay, the same rules. When both are having the same sign, that is both are having same plus sign or minus sign, and when they are having different signs, so how we are going to proceed, how we are going to do the addition and subtraction of the binary numbers using binary number. That's what we have signed binary numbers. Okay. Now, we'll see the how it can be implemented in CPU. That's what we are going to see now. So before that, we'll see there is an arithmetic processor, which is very much necessary for, that is ALU, arithmetic and logical unit, present in CPU is the one which carry over all these additions and comparisons. All those things, all the logical operations. So arithmetic instructions in digital computers, they manipulate data to produce results necessary for the solution of the computational problems. So an arithmetic process, a part of the processor unit that executes arithmetic operations. And an arithmetic instruction, it may specify binary or decimal data. And in each case, the data may be in a fixed point or floating point form. So arithmetic process is very simple if it only handles binary fixed point, okay, and add instruction. But normally it is not so because it will include fractional form as well as floating point. There is floating point number also will be there. So it may be more complicated if it includes all 4 arithmetic operations for binary and decimal data in fixed point and floating point of representation. Now we'll see. Before going through that, what is an algorithm? An algorithm is stated as a finite number of well-defined procedural steps to solve a problem. Because for example, if you want to solve if you want to find a factorial of a number, then you have to get the proper input. You have to mention what are all the input. Then you have to give the logic in which you can use, in which you can find the fractional, that is factorial number, and finally you will output the answer. So for this, you will write an algorithm. So an algorithm, step by step, you will write. Here, in order to represent, another way of representing the algorithm is using flowchart. It is a pictorial representation. Okay, so now we'll see what are all the pictures or the symbols used for in flowchart. This is used for this symbol. It's used for star dot end. Some oval represent oval shape. Then arrow shows the flow of the data, flow of the program. After which, what will be the next? Like step one, step two. Instead of writing step one, step two, you will use the arrow. So that what will be the based on that arrow, the next step you will be representing the what is the next step. Then this is for in getting input output. Then this is for processing, and this is for taking any decision. Okay, whether A is greater than B. If A is greater than B, then what we have to do. If it is not, this B is greater, what has to be done. So all these things you can using that this diamond shape, you can represent the decision making process. So data types considered for the arithmetic operations, etc. Fixed point binary data in signed magnitude representation, fixed point binary data in signed 2's complement, then floating point binary data and binary coded decimal PCD. So negative fixed point binary numbers are represented as negative can be represented in 3 ways. One is using the sign you can represent, and the magnitude is what is the particular value. Then using the most significant bit, you can say whether it is a positive or negative. If it is a negative, No, you can represent it with one. Most significant bit has to be represented with the one, indicating the next data followed is a negative number. Then signed ones complement, you can represent it using ones complement, where you convert the given data, invert all the values. If it is one, you would become zero, zero becomes one. Then twos complement is finding ones complement, adding one with it will give you the twos complement. So a negative element can be represented in three ways. Now we'll see that. So here, say for example, if this is a value, then one means it is, here one is present, it means it is a negative number. If it is zero, it is a positive number. Now, what are all the main support, main thing needed for this calculation of addition, subtraction, etc.? Definitely you need a parallel adder, because you'll be adding more than one, more than two bits. For example, A may consist of 8 bits, B may consist of 8 bits. So you'll be adding 8 bit with A is 8 bit with B is 8 bit. So parallelly you will add. So you need a parallel adder in order to perform the operation A plus B. Then while taking a decision, say for example, I want to do a subtraction A minus B. You may want to know which is greater, whether A is greater or B is greater. Depending upon that, you will substitute the bigger numbers sign. Okay. So in order to do that, you will compare. So for that, you need a comparator circuit. Then a subtractor, two parallel subtractors in order to do A minus B and B minus C. But all these things can be done with a single thing called parallel adder. The subtraction can be achieved by means of complement and addition. So this needs only an adder and a complementer. We'll see that. See here, this gives an overall view. A B register and this is the A register. These two values to be added. Let us consider. Now, there is a through a mod bit. There will be a mod bit. You can give a 0 or a 1. Okay. So there will be a complementer. In order to complement them, if it is a subtraction, then B value will be complemented. And then in order to find the 2's complement, first it will be complemented. And if M is equal to 1, then you are going to find the 2's complement, right? Then that will be added, and the parallel adder A and the 2's complement of B will be added. And if there is any carry, that will be stored in E. And the most significant bit of this B register, that is MSB, is nothing but our sign bit. Okay, this is add overflow. When during addition, you have any overflow that can be stored here also. So A plus B is done by the parallel adder. So here, if it is 8 bits are there, 7 bits will be there, and the last MSB bit, 8 bit will be here. It is nothing but our sign bit. Okay, so the 7 bits will be added parallelly with the A register 7 bits. Now, here, when M equal to 0, this mod bit plays an important part. So when M is 0, this acts as an adder. So whatever is in B, it exactly goes in the complementer also. There will be no reversal. Okay, there is no conversion. 0 to 1, 1 to 0 and all. That will be when it is 0, A and B are added. When M equal to 1, now the same thing acts as a subtractor, and the complement of B is formed. And then 1 is added. This is nothing but equal to 2's complement. And then finally, it will add, that is A minus B will be formed. So the same will be used as a subtractor also. Now we'll see the hardware algorithm of addition and subtraction. Now let us consider this. When A is one value and B is one value, let us take during add operation. A register, the value in register A is called again, and
in B, the data in B is called added. Okay. Now, the first sign bit is XOR. So we know the formula of XOR. When both the values are same, you will get a zero. When there is an odd number or the values of A and B are different, then you will get a one as an output in an XOR. So here, when both are one, you know the value will be zero. When both are zero also, you'll get a zero, which means the sign bit is same. So when the sign bit is same, then you have to do the addition. Then you are checking whether A is the sign, both the sign of A is equal to, when both are equal, which means the sign bit of A and B both are same. In the case, you add A plus B and you store it in a register EA. Then if any overflow, that will be stored in AVF flag. Okay, and we have completed the task. Suppose they are different. The value, the sign bit of A and B are different. That is, one is subtraction, that is, and another is, the one is minus and another one is a negative value. So in that case, when you are XORing 0, XOR 1, then you will have 1 as output. So in which case you have to do the subtraction. So it comes here. Now what you do, you find the 2's complement of B and add with A. And so because of the subtraction, there will be no overflow. Okay. So now you check the value of E. That is, here, here you will have the, when you add, whether you have a carry or not. So in this case, you check. If it is equal to 1, then you check whether the value of A is greater than B. Okay, whether, because here we are doing A plus B bar. Whether we, here we are doing subtraction. So whether after subtraction, you have to substitute the bigger value sign. Okay, so for that you do a check here. A is greater than B. If A is greater than B, if that is equal to 0, then that is true. If it is true, then you make the A sign bit equal to 0 because it is a positive number. A is bigger means A is positive. So therefore the result, because again, when you do this, again the value is stored in A after doing A plus 2's complement of B. So that is again stored in A only. So the sign, the result of the sign, this is nothing but the result. The result of the sign, you make it as 0, which is positive. Okay. If it is not equal to 0, then you end here for further processing. Okay. Now we'll see about the subtraction. This is what we have seen in addition, in the signs are different. Okay, during subtraction, suppose in this case, so we have to see, check. If E is, if it is 1, then you check for A is greater than B. If it is 0, then you know that A is lesser value. So what you do is, you find the complement of A, because now you have to find the opposite sign of A. It is nothing but B's sign, you can say. So A complement, and you find 2's complement of A. That is the last sign bit. And then you put the sign bit here. Now, if you want to find the subtraction, okay, let us say mind you, one value is in A and subtrahend is in B. Now, again, you check the sign bit. If it is equal to 0 means both the sign bit are same. So A is equal to B, is same sign. So in this case, what you have to do, again, you have to subtract. But for that, B value, B, for 2's complement of B, you will find and then add with A. And all the other options are same. If both are 1, that is, if the sign bit is different, then you go here. Okay, you have to add. So here we are doing the addition operation. Because say for example, minus A and plus B, let us imagine. In that case, sign bit is different. So here you, what you do is you add those two values and any overflow that will be stored in AVF flag.